How the hell do they get the torpedoes from here to there? Are you telling me these people actually have to pick these things up and manually load them in? What kind of a stupid system is it? Like, look, there's barely any torpedoes in here. How the hell are we supposed to fire hundreds of torpedoes a second? This isn't on. We're gonna have to change all this. I'm the Hotfoot and welcome to Star Trek Online. Oh, I've been meaning to record this one for quite some time. I have actually played the game on PC. I've played it three times over. No, I played it two times over. Or is it four? I played it once as an engineer, once as a science officer, starting in the 23rd century, and I'm also playing it as a Klingon. In fact, as you know, I played it twice as a human. The other one was actually a tactical officer. So this time, though, we're playing it, as you might notice, by all the little buttons in that down the bottom that are appearing. I am recording, aren't I? Yes, I am. By all the little buttons that appear down the bottom there, that this is on the PlayStation. So this is the PlayStation release of Star Trek Online. I had actually intended on recording this when it was first released. So I've obviously fallen a little bit behind on that one. All that aside, we're going to start a new character. Now, you can see that I do currently have a Lieutenant Commander on the PlayStation here. His name is Mackenzie. His full name is actually something else, but I'm not going to bother with you that one, because we're going to create a new character. So, let's see here. Now, we're going to go Starfleet, because everybody loves the Federation. Personally, I'm partial to either the Klingons or the Romulans. I love their ships. They are some kick-ass war ships. But we're going Starfleet. This is a time of war for the Federation, so they do have some really good ships to play with. And we are going to go human. We're going to keep it simple. We're going to go a male human, because, as I always do in these kind of games, I like to make the character look like me. I don't know how I was going to go about this, whether or not I would just continue on with the character I already had, Mackenzie, or if I would create a new one. I figured I'll create a new one. Now, I normally prefer to play as the Engineer class, because the Engineer class gets some really cool tech. But for this, we're going to go tactical. I did also consider whether or not we might do it as a science class, because that's what Star Trek was all about when it started, you know, exploration, finding new species and shooting them in the face. But it's the shooting in the face part that a lot of people really appeal to, and that's where tactical comes in. So we're going for the tactical guy. Now, we're going to start off with a preset here just to get us a base, because, like I said, I always like to make the character look like myself. Now, I will try not to spend too much time of this video on this. I want to at least get through one or two missions per video. Nobody asked you, phone. Shut up. Sorry, let me just put that on silent. Phone's on silent now. It should only vibrate. In fact, let's put it over there. Well, check this out. This is what I've had to do with my microphone to get good audio. That is sitting inside a soda box. Soda can box with a blanket over it to absorb all the sound. Because my last recording, you might have noticed in the Battlefield with Friends, the voice recording wasn't too great. Now, it might have been because I may have forgotten to change some settings on there, but I sort of decided I'm going to put that in the box to cancel out a lot of the outside noise so that the only voice it is picking up is me. So it's open towards me, so my voice goes in there and that's all it hears. What I would actually like to do, and I'll probably actually continue using this box until I get a proper setup, is put some sound padding inside the box to help with the recording and make it so that I can stand the box up vertical instead of having it lying the way it is now. But anyway, back to this. Enough about that boring crap. Let's get back to Star Trek Online. So, who should I start with? I need someone that's going to look relatively like me. He doesn't look anything like me. I've got a very pronounced jawline, as is evident by a cartoon picture that I had drawn of me once. And I look at it and I think, that really looks like me. Now, this guy's pretty close, but no. Not because of the skin colour. Come on, people, stop being racist. I'm going to go this guy, but we're going to make a lot of modifications. This guy's a bit too old. Now, I'm going to try and not spend too much of the video on this. Eye colour, very wrong, so let's just quickly change that while we're here. We do have white eyes, but I have blue eyes. Skin colour, I am pale as hell. That's as pale as it's going to let me go, so alright. Alright, tattoos and scars. Well, This is a little detail I always like to do. I always like to do a bit of a scar somewhere. To there. There we go. That looks pretty cool, I think. That's pretty rad, that one. We'll turn down the intensity and make it just a nice little bit of a light feature. Yeah, that looks pretty good, I think. I've got a bit of grey happening in the beard and the mustache. A bit around here. I've even got some happening up here as well, there and there. See, this is the thing for me when it comes to these sort of games, is there's so much detail that can go into it. And yet, for some reason, no matter how much you change things, it doesn't seem to do anything. Right, the width of the nose. I do not have a big, wide nose. I've got something of an average nose. Look at that. Is that not a man who commands? That's what that looks like to me. Alrighty then. Where am I going with my accent? Why is my accent changing? That's not even my accent. Alright. Now, height. Yeah, that looks pretty good. Yeah. 6 foot. Let's be realistic. I am... there. Actually. Yeah. There. Yep. Feet size. Yes, I got big feet. Feet width. Yep. I love these uniforms. They are the best. It is a uniform that I am going to make. Let's just keep zooming in and out here till everybody gets sick. But I am enjoying this one. This one is pretty cool. I'm going to change the uniform of this guy. We are going for something traditional. But we're going to just fix it up a bit because I don't completely agree with the colours. Rank pips. Not silver. They are not silver. They are gold. Gold rank pips, people. Gold. Yep, next gen film. However, not silver. Not all silver again. The center bit, silver. Yes. That bit is silver, I think. Hold on. Yeah, right. All right. This bit is gold. So there we go. There. That is the proper comm badge. There we go. My pants are loose. I have feet. And here's where we're going to move away from the norm, because I like the addition of a belt on this uniform. I really do think it makes it just so much better. So we're going to the next gen uniform with an Odyssey belt. Alright, cool. Done. Uniform done. How much time did we waste? We wasted 23 minutes on creating a character. I had a keyboard. Oh well. H-O-P-F-O... T. There it is. Up, up. Now, we need a ship name. Now, what's a good ship name? Good ship name. Good ship lollipop. That's a good ship name. But we're not going to do that. This one, I'm going to name it. But I'll tell you what. If you want to come up with a suggestion for naming of the next ship, put it in the comments below at the end of the video. Or go down there and do it now. Put some comments in there. Say, oh, your next ship should be this. But this one, let's call it USS Hopton. No, that's stupid. No, the ship wouldn't be named after me. That's silly. All right, we'll do something Star Trek-y. We'll pick something with a Greek-Roman theme about it. Let's call it... Mercury. Mercury. Yeah, let's call it that. Mercury. I like Mercury. Nice little planet. And Mercury is a planet. Do you know why Mercury is a planet? Because it fits into the category of a planet. Go look up the categorization of planets and dwarf planets, known as Plutoids. If you're still hung up on Pluto, go look up the reason why it was demoted. Go look it up. Not right now. Stay here. No, get. Sit down. Sit. Get back here. I'm watching you. All right. Mercury. The USS Mercury. Engage. So again, yes, if you want to make some suggestions for the name of the next ship, again, leave them in the comments below, and I will pick my favourite. So, whatever you say down there, I'll pick my favourite for the next ship. Of course, if, as is probably usually the case when I do this sort of thing, if we don't have any name suggestions by the time I get a new ship, I will of course just be naming it myself. Probably going in a similar theme to this, with a Roman sort of Greek theming on the name. Let's go through the tutorial. Good reason actually to go through the tutorial. I skipped it once. Bad idea. go through the tutorial because you do get XP during the tutorial. So, I'd like to play the tutorial. Pretty sure you get XP in the tutorial. Okay, so we've skipped through that. There was a video clip back there. Unfortunately, due to copyright reasons, I will not be including that in this video. I won't be including any video clips of such in the video. You might have noticed that there is no music so far. That is because I have turned the music off. Welcome to Star Trek Online. Today is graduation day, and soon you will embark on your training cruise, where the bulk of the ship is manned by cadets like yourself. This tutorial will introduce you to the basic controls of Star Trek Online, including movement, combat, and interacting with characters and objects. Continue. Am I supposed to go over there? Move forward.
The left stick controls your player movement. The right stick controls your camera.
My cadet uniform looks like shit. Looks like shitty. Alright. Yep, talk to her.
Finally, I was beginning to think you forgot what today was.
How could I? You've reminded me every day for the past month, you bitch. You just never shut up. I wish you would, but you don't. Did you get your assignment?
Of course, I was first in line. Oh, before I forget, I think Rasky is just ahead. He wanted to thank you for helping him cram for the astrometrics for him.
Oh, the little dick should have bloody studied more. Otherwise, I wouldn't have to help him. Alright, moving on ahead.
There you are. I wanted to thank you for helping me pass that final. And for all the other
times. Just gonna turn this up a bit.
I've always admired you. I hope Starfleet recognizes all you've done to lead our class. What ship did you get?
I haven't received my assignment yet.
Good luck. Before you report to Lieutenant Farah and get your assignment, you should find Tevrel. She wanted to talk to you. She's just up the pathway.
Right, I can barely hear that. Just give me 1 second. I've got to switch headphones here. I can barely hear it on these ones. Unfortunately, I have to use these ones, and they're freaking broken. Yeah, seriously, people. The PlayStation brand headphones. You may have noticed, I've got taped up on this side. I now have to tape them up on this side. I haven't done it yet because they only just broke a few minutes ago. In fact, they only just broke just over half an hour ago. I've had these for a year. I've taken good care of them. But the hinge has broken. So, PlayStation, get your shit together, Sony. These ones are a bit better, though. Unfortunately, than using those earphones. I had the controller somewhere. Where the put? There it is. Right. Okay, so we've got to head over here now. Talk to Tevrel.
Greetings.
Evening, baby. Rasky said you had something to tell me.
It was good of you to encourage me to retake the linguistics final. I was willing to accept my original results, but you saw that I was not at my best that day. My score increased by 12.8% on the second attempt, well within my standard norms. Now I am qualified to serve as both a science officer and a communications officer.
Huh? What? So, you're like Uhura and Spock combined? Pretty damn good looking for a Spock. My fiance didn't hear that, thankfully. She's asleep. Love you, sweetie.
Morik would like to see you as well. He is ahead of us on the path. Live long and prosper.
I can't remember the response to live long and prosper. There's something that you can say back that's slightly different. I don't know. Live long and prosper. Wait, is it that way? Or is it that way? I can never remember which way is the thumb. Is the thumb next to or is the thumb apart? Say it in the comment below which way it is. Thumb apart or thumb together?
Your minimap shows you where your objectives are. An arrow will appear on the minimap if you are far away from your objective.
Uh-huh. Thank you. Hey, ugly.
There you are. Getting excited yet? Once we finish our training cruise, we'll all be full-fledged ensigns. The buzz is, Captain Taggart hasn't named all of his senior staff yet.
Taggart.
From what I heard, the advanced phaser training simulation is tripping people up.
Thanks. Jesus, it's hard enough as it is. I don't need this extra stress.
Good afternoon.
You're less ugly than the other guy.
What can I do for you?
Is this where I get my training cruise assignment?
Yes. I have the complete assignment list here. Name?
Hopfer.
Let's see. Interesting. Report to Captain Taggart. He's in the office behind me.
Is there a problem?
You're going to have to ask him.
Okay. I hate being called to the principal's office.
Objects you can interact with have a glow around them. Press the X button to interact with the doorbell to notify Captain Taggart of your presence.
Come.
I swear, it wasn't my fault. The other guy, the red guy, he hadn't studied. I helped him. If he copied my answers, it's not my fault.
Cadet.
You asked to see me, sir.
I did. I've been following your progress here at the Academy, and I must say, I'm impressed.
Why, thank you, James Bond. I mean, Captain.
I'm just looking at your final test scores, but I don't see your results for the Advanced Phaser Training Program.
I swear, he sounds like almost a little bit like Sean Connery, James Bond. I know that program is advised for tactical officers, sir, but I thought I had more time to take it. Any of my classmates didn't take the test either, Captain. Is that an issue? I know that program is advised for tactical officers, sir, but I thought I had more time to take it.
I want everyone on my senior staff to run that program, and I want to see good results, no exceptions.
Did you say senior staff?
I did. Like Woo-hoo! I said, I've been following your career here at the Academy. If you complete that program, I can put you on my bridge. I'll ask my tactical officer to set it up.
Tactical officer, sir? Who is that?
Another fine cadet like yourself. Her scores were almost as good as yours, but her record has a few blemishes. Still, I'm sure Cadet Flores will settle down and become a fine officer someday.
Yes, sir.
I'll tell Flores to meet you out in the quad. Talk to her to start the phaser training, and I'll see you when you're finished. You're dismissed, Cadet.
Yes, sir. Automatic door! Woo! Jesus, sound was a bit late. Hey, bitch! Guess what?
I got the tactical officer spot. Just what I wanted. Where'd you end up?
Captain Taggart says he wants me on the senior staff. But I have to pass advanced phaser training first. Fuck!
You never did that? I thought you were Mr. Extra Credit. Everyone knows that Captain Taggart expects all his top people to pass that program.
Well, now you tell me!
Don't worry, you'll do fine. Come on, I'll take you to the holodeck and set it up.
Lead the way, bitch!
Seems most of our class ended up on Captain Taggart's ship.
Uh-huh. What a surprise. You're taking too long. I'm taking a shortcut. Seriously, I have to follow you? Fuck's sake, you're gonna take me on the freaking scenic route, aren't you?
Have you seen the whales in San Francisco Bay? I never seem to spot them. I sometimes forget that Boothby is a hologram. He seems like such a fixture here at Starfleet Academy.
To sprint, press and hold the left stick while moving.
I don't see any whales. But wait, hang on. Did you say Boothby's a hologram? Where is he? Wait, does that mean Boothby's dead? Boothby? Wait, has he always been a hologram? I'll have to look that up. Ooh, what's this? Ooh. Clock. Class. Blah, blah, blee, blah, blue, blah, blah. The fuck are the whales? Yeah. Let's keep going. Come on.
Last one of the console buys the first round tonight.
You bitch. Yeah, you say that when you're ahead of me.
Setting up the training program now. I hope holodeck 2 is your lucky holodeck.
I'll need a phaser.
Phasers are in the lockers by the holodecks. You can grab one there.
Let's go.
Press the left button to scan the area. Your tricorder will point you toward your nearest objective.
That way. I'm so good I can run cross-eyed. Oh wait, oh shit, whoops, I'm so good, I'm stupid.
The pistol has been automatically equipped. Go to the center of the room.
Okay. Ooh. Pretty.
The
hell are you shooting at? I'm over here, dipshit.
While in combat, certain actions are disabled. Once you drop out of combat, more detail about ground combat will become available.
Okay.
Hold the triangle button to holster and draw your weapon.
Captain.
Well done, cadet. You're not going to break the academy record, but your score was more than satisfactory.
Thank you, Captain. Do you have an assignment for me now?
Absolutely. I have a new first officer. Congratulations.
First officer? Sir?
Yes. You should be proud of your accomplishments here, cadet. You have a promising career ahead of you in Starfleet.
Thank you, sir. It will be an honor serving with you.
First officer, way to go. Just a little jealous, I'll admit. At least now you'll get to boss us all around like you've always wanted.
What can I say? The captain sees greatness in me.
Don't let it go to your head, buddy.
I won't.
You'll do great. But we should head up to the shuttle bay. Everyone else is waiting there for the ceremonial send-off toast.
Alright. Let's go. Beach to the shuttle bay! Yeah, see, I can play at that game too. Which way is the shuttle bay? Is
that now, hear this. All cadets report to shuttle bay to prepare for departure.
See you later, bitch.
Okay,
hey,
the senior staff is waiting.
How'd you get here?
I'm sure everyone's a bit nervous, this being our first real assignment. So, I'm expecting an inspiring speech out of you. Something heartwarming. Make Tavrell cry.
Hey, giving speeches.
This could determine the rest of our careers. No pressure. I'll meet you over there.
Go fuck yourself. No, I'll meet you over there. Bam! Lead toast to the class of 24. This is the entire class. You fucking shitting me. This is everyone. Who the fuck are you three? You, and you. Who the hell are you three? Never seen you before. Alright. Graduation day? League toast, there we go. Spy of the cadets! We are the senior staff of the USS Mercury. Each and every one of us is trained for the task at hand. We are ready. I look around this room and I see fear and uncertainty in your eyes. Being responsible for so many lives is a heavy burden. but we will go forth, boldly like Starfleet has trained us, putting to use everything we've learned here. To Starfleet Academy, to the USS Mercury, to her crew.
All cadets, please board your shuttles.
To the shuttles! Deck officer! Deck officer!
Are you ready to head to the ship?
Yes. Seriously, we have transporters. Why are we bothering with shuttles?
I can't believe we're finally doing this.
That is not the interior of a Class 2 shuttle. That is barely the interior of the shuttle I can't remember the name of.
First of her class. She's got subsystem targeting, a crew of 750, auxiliary phaser cannons, and quantum field focus controller.
Yeah, alright, I gotcha.
Wait to captain one someday.
Yeah, we better turn
that
down.
But here's our ship.
Woohoo!
Miranda class, 200 crew, 2 forward weapon mounts, 1 aft, average speed, warp 5.0. She's a tough little ship, though. I think I like her.
Damn right, bitch. You're a bit harsh on her.
Shuttle to arrive. We need to get to the bridge.
She's a bit harsh on it. It's a fucking awesome ship. This thing's gonna kick some ass. This is our ship!
I'm going to check in and then head for the bridge. See you there.
Okay.
Name and position?
Cadet Hopford, Acting First Officer.
I have your record right here, sir. Welcome to the ship.
She called me sir. Where is the captain?
Captain Taggart is waiting for you on the bridge. Use the turbo lift behind me.
Will you shut up? I'm trying to listen to what she's saying. I'm sorry. Continue. Oh, you don't? Oh, alright. Turbo lift! Turbo lift! Go! To the bridge. Captain?
To the bridge, number one.
Number one?
Early in my career, I served with a captain who called his first officer that. I always liked it. As my number one, I expect you to ensure my orders are carried out, and to advise me on the best course of action in any situation. But first, we need to get out of dry dock, get clearance from control, and close the shuttle bay doors, then disable the tractor moorings.
Throw, get clearance from traffic control for the Mercury to leave the gantry.
Earth traffic control has cleared us to depart, sir.
Very good, number one.
Floors, send the signal to close the shuttle bay doors.
Shuttle bay doors are closed, sir.
I said send the signal, not just fucking close. You just crushed a shuttle that was coming through the door. Jesus Christ, woman. God, you're a bitch.
Very good, number one.
Potter, wait for me to disable the tractor moorings. Tractor moorings. Over here. Ha! Beep, 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 beep. Life forms, tiny little life forms. Where are you? What about this sheep? Is it in this one? Oh, I want to sit down. Fuck it, I'll stand.
Potter, take us out. 1/4 impulse.
Captain, may I remind you that Starfleet regulations specify thrusters only while in the vicinity of space dock.
Just checking to see if you were paying attention, number one. Potter, take us out. Maximum thrusters.
To sit, press the X button while targeting the chair you wish to sit in.
I am pressing the X button. Let's try this one. Oh, I'm supposed to sit in this chair. Whoops! Oh yeah, that makes sense. First officer always sits on the right. What is with the audio in my ears? Must be this bloody cable I'm using.
Cleared from dry dock, Captain.
Good. Let's start with something easy. Set course for Vulcan.
Course lead in, sir.
Engage.
Hey, were you at the speech? I feel kind of odd because I like... Oh wait, no, I don't have a different uniform. I was about to say, I have a different uniform from
I am picking up
else.
A distress call from the SS Break-Even. Audio only.
Let's hear it, Tavrell.
This is the SS Break-Even. Our warp core is failing, and we are in need of assistance.
Let them know we're on our way. Potter, lay in a
You can just tell from the voice it's a Ferengi.
ETA 3 minutes.
Transporter room, prepare to beam over survivors.
Sir, sensors can't read anything in the vicinity of the break-even.
Communications are out as well.
Keep trying to hail them, Tavrell. Number one, let's discuss the situation.
Well, a ship has called for distress, and we're gonna go and help them?
Call number one, what do you think we should do?
Is this a test, sir? Part of the training course, cruise?
Absolutely not. We're the closest ship to the break-even, so it's our duty to assist.
Wasn't there just another ship at Space Dock that's closer and faster? Strange that the transmission was audio only. A warp core emergency shouldn't affect communications.
Good. What do you advise?
Let's see. I recommend we go to the Red Alert. Full power of the weapons, a low fire. That's a bit eager, I think. We need more information before we get there. I recommend scanning for an hour to see exactly what the situation is. If we're wrong, they could blow up within an hour. Shields up, sir. Better safer than sorry.
Raising the shields does seem to be a reasonable precaution.
Yes, sir. It could be a trap.
I agree. Flores, raise shields. Number one, get down to the transporter room. You'll oversee the rescue effort from the...
Yes, sir. This one. Transport deck? Fairly sure all they would say was transport the room. Rurik, the break even should be in range. Give me an update.
I'm getting some weird readings.
Jesus Christ, there's a fucking huge console in front of him. He's not even touching the console.
I can't get a solid lock. There may be interference. Trying to compensate. I think I have it.
This is. Who's this guy? A midget?
Training scenarios. Beaming them over now. Klingons!
This vessel is
Klingons.
The property of
Captain Get them off!
Of the IKS Chunk.
Hang on, with the shields raised, how did he beam them? Rurik, come in! What happened? Rurik! Rurik!
Doc, security is reporting disruptive fire in the transporter room, and Klingon transporter signatures are showing up all over the ship. They're boarding us!
No shit, Sherlock! What can I do to help?
You have the command codes to unlock an armory near your position. Arm yourself, and any security team members you find.
What about the enemy ship, sir?
We still have weapons. I'll do what I can. For now, I need you to concentrate on getting those Klingons off my ship. Tag it out.
Yes, sir. To the weapons locker. Hey, bitches, what's up? You need in? Here, let me get this. Beep. Beep, 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 beep.
The armory locker in this room and interact with it to get a better weapon.
No. Let's see what's in here. Yeah, I'll take that. So press black button. Do you mind? I'm trying to concentrate. There we go.
An object has dropped for you. Look near the item and it will be automatically added to your inventory.
That's nice. Jesus, they're hitting us hard. Bye bye. Have a wonderful time. Okay, can't go in there. Where are we going? We're going this way. Pew! Pew! Bang, 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 bang. Bang, bang. You know what? This thing's better. Yeah. Hand phaser's better. Rifle sucks. Jesus Christ, calm the hell down. I heal you! You healed! Hit hole. Yeah, this is better. Open sesame.
Number one, we're doing our best to cripple this Klingon Marauder, but I need your help.
I know how to improve the ship's weapons. You're taking too long to talk. Move along. That one. No? There we go. I knew there was a way to get it to work. Oh, thank God the explosions have stopped. Search weapon!
Press the right stick to crouch. Crouching gives a defensive bonus against
melee. I did a barrel roll!
Damage from melee attacks.
Dual barrel roll! Dual barrel roll! Breach the door. Shoot. Bang, bang, bang. For fuck's sake. Bad person. Bad person. Bad cleaner. Down boy. Girl, whatever you were. Now we can shoot him. What the hell was that all about? Yep, you're fine. What am I doing? Am I pressing buttons on here? No. Here? No. What the hell am I supposed to do? I breached the door. Now what? Is there another door? The game's broken. You're kidding me. Game broke! Alright. Boost power. it's those torpedoes. Boost power to these ones. Damn it. How the hell do they get the torpedoes from here to there? Are you telling me these people actually have to pick these things up and manually load them in? What kind of a stupid system is it? Like, look, there's barely any torpedoes in here. How the hell are we supposed to fire hundreds of torpedoes a second? This isn't on. We're going to have to change all this. Look, I'm pressing buttons without my hands.
Number one, I've ended up here and the Klingons could send a boarding party at any time. I need you back on the bridge.
Aisa!
Go see to the bridge. We will secure this area.
Okay. It's a long run back. All the way home. Show me the way to get home. 'Cause I'm drunk off my face. I can't sing for crap. Who needs shooting? You need shooting. Pow, pow. Pew, pew. Pew, pew, pew. No. I beat you with the butt of my gun, bitch. You are the bitch now. Ooh, what's going on out there? I see a ship. There's a ship. 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 Who's shooting me? You are. Whack. Pew. I defeated the Klingons. I defeated the Klingons. I defeated the Klingons. Someone up here is injured. Get up, Tavrea. We need you. You are our science officer. You there, Ruzki, you weak little piece of piss. I helped you get through class. Now get up.
Incoming transmission from the Klingons.
On screen.
This is Captain Kayak of the IKS Chot. You may have forced my boarding parties off your decks, but our ship remains cloaked. You have no hope of finding us or defeating us. Your choice is simple. Surrender, or we will kill your captain and then destroy your ship.
Never!
Perhaps your captain will change your mind.
Captain?
Order your crew to surrender, Captain, or I will blow them out of the sky. It's your choice, Captain. Do you want these children to die?
Very well. Number one.
Yes, Captain.
You are now the captain of the ship. Your orders. Your orders are to lock onto my combat and fire!
Hiya, daughter!
You dare! Captain, no! Captain, whatever you. What was his name?
Make.
Taggart!
Me. Proud.
Yes, sir! That, yeah, that was coming, of course.
We have target lock, Captain.
Fire. Boom! Take that, you clean on bastards! Ain't gonna help ya!
We've lost their signal. What now?
Now, the hunt is on. Wait, bitch. I need to talk to you.
We survived. But the captain... Captain Taggart knew what happened. And he gave the order...
Seriously. We're in combat situation here. No time for this shit.
He trusted you to take command. All we can do now...
Well, I'm taking command. What do the five fingers say to your face? Slap! Snap out of it, woman! Taking command. Oh, excuse me. Oh, bloody flu.
Elisa Flores is now your bridge officer.
Woohoo!
Bridge officers add abilities to your ship in space. Accompany you on away missions on the ground.
All decks reporting in, sir. We took some casualties, and sick bay is full. All ship systems have taken some damage, but some are worse than others. Life support is stable, but anything else could be an issue.
Tavrel, send out a distress call.
I have been trying to get a distress call out, Captain, but something is jamming all frequencies.
Keep trying. Elisa, what's the status of the Klingon ship?
She's still cloaked, but I think she took some real damage. We're in rough shape too, Captain.
Salva, damage report.
Still running diagnostics, sir. Took us some time to get the systems back online.
What about the break-even? Hail them, Tavril.
Hailing the break-even now, Captain.
SS Break-Even, this is the Starfleet vessel USS Mercury. What's your status?
Hello, Starfleet. No,
told you it was a Ferengi.
Tried. I had to send that distress signal. If I didn't, that crazy Klingon was going to blow my ship into space junk. And, because Starfleet's always ready to help and all, could you help me repair my ship? I'm grateful for all you've done to save my ship and cargo already. But the sooner I can get out of here, the sooner I'll be safe from K-Deck.
I'll see what we can do.
Press up to
bloody Ferengis.
Press down to decrease your ship speed. Use the left stick to pitch
That's
downward or up.
Kill transmission.
As well as to turn left or right.
Like this. Alright, speed up. And we are set for weapons fire.
Helm, full stop. I've stopped us this time, sir, but from now on, you'll be responsible for adjusting the speed of the ship.
Who the fuck is command of this ship? Me! You dare stop this ship again, bitch, and I will slap you again. Scan the freighter.
Looks like she just needs 3 or 4 warp induction coils. We have plenty of those to spare.
Position yourself near the ships and press the X button to interact with them.
Repair the freighter. Okay, so we're transporting the stuff.
Thanks! We'd help you if we could, but I just don't see any profit in that, you know?
Typical fucking Ferengi.
Well, looks like we're on our own. At least they said thank you, I guess. About that cloaked ship full of Klingons?
Sava, do you have that damage report?
Almost done, Captain. Level 2 diagnostic shows that almost all of the plasma injectors are damaged beyond repair.
Do you have replacements?
Not enough. Plasma injectors are made to withstand quite a beating, but I think the Klingons specifically sabotaged them when they boarded us. It's an easy way to cripple a ship. I'm installing what spares we have, but we're short 3 injectors. Without them, we can't go to warp.
Thank you. Any ideas, bitch?
We're not the first ship the Klingons have hit here. There's wreckage all over this region. I can scan the derelicts and see if any of them have intact plasma injectors.
Do it.
Bingo! I found some suitable debris in the boneyard nearby. Destroy 3 of those nacelles, and we should get the parts we need.
Okay.
Press the R2 button to fire energy weapons.
That one.
An item has dropped for you. Push the item to automatically loot it.
Taking through scraps we've left behind.
Yeah, that guy's getting annoying.
You turn the comms off. God, you're a whingy bitch. Ship is so slow. It's so slow. Come on. You can do it. Move faster. God, this is slow. Hoping I can zoom my map in up on the mini-map. Seems a bit too far out. Yep, got that one. And normally on the PC you have to actually grab things and you can only like do it if you're not under attack and most of the time. I'd say, when it comes to the controls...
injectors will do the trick, sir. Gorgeous technology. Type R if I had to guess. 3.7 liter flow put with shielded reservoirs and a drop flow induction coil.
That's good. But remember the Klingon who wants us dead? I need you to work fast.
You have your problems, I have mine. I'll need some time to get everything installed and run a level 1 diagnostic. We don't want to blow up the moment we hit warp 1.
that's a good thing. Bitchface, give me a status report.
Zarva's dealing with the Warp Corp, but until she's done, we're still stranded out here with no way to call for help. Oh, don't forget the cloaked Klingon battlecruiser. It's probably making repairs faster than we are.
Any chance we can determine what's jamming communications in this system?
Of course we can. We're the class of 2409. Tevrel's been working with the engineers, and they've pinpointed the locations of several Klingon signal jammers. That's what blocked our communications during the ambush. I recommend that we destroy the jamming satellites. We'll be able to get a call out to Starfleet then.
Sounds good.
You must be within 10 kilometers of an enemy to attack it. Use your plasma beam to weaken shielded targets.
Wait for it.
Nice shot. Two more jamming satellites.
Are operational, sir. Shall I send the distress signal?
Send the signal.
That Klingon ship took some real damage. I'll bet she's leaking plasma all over the place. We might be able to use that to find them.
Do it. We need to find them before he ambushes us again.
Understood. I'd rather not die to Klingons on my first day. Got it. I can trace the plasma signature right to the source.
Finally. We have the advantage.
I'll send the source of the plasma signature to navigation. It will show up on the map.
Make it so.
It's pretty far out, sir. We should use the ship's full impulse power to reach it.
About
this will temporarily take power from other systems, but vastly improve our speed. Once we drop out of full impulse, the power will return to other systems.
You talk too much.
I can make your death swift.
Hold up on the D-pad to activate and deactivate full impulse.
I could just press out L1. You know, because that works. Follow the plasma trail, follow. Bring us a belt! Proton torpedoes, high yield! Fire! Target the other ship. Did I say proton torpedoes? Oops. Wrong franchise.
Think you can catch me? Go ahead and try.
I will.
Press the circle button to activate high yield torpedo.
Yeah, I just frickin' did that.
High yield torpedo will increase the power.
Yeah, shut up. Do or do not. There is no try. Mixing the franchise. Prepare for high yield torpedoes. Phases, fire. Fire the torpedoes. Actually, there we go. Get both phases in range. Yeah. Kick his ass. Yeah.
Distance between yourself and exploding ships.
Okay. Go away.
Incoming transmission, sir. It is from Starfleet.
Unscreen, Tavarro.
This is Captain Volok of the USS Renown. Do you require assistance?
Yes, sir. We were ambushed by Klingon marauders, but you know what? We took out several of their ships. I'm pretty sure we could probably do all right, but if you're willing to give us the help, we'll take it.
A Klingon captain would have to be very bold to travel this far into Federation territory. Where is Captain Taggart?
He was captured and taken to the Klingon ship. They killed him after he ordered us to fire on his position.
And did you follow his orders?
Yes, sir.
So, I take it you are in command now.
No shit.
Very well. We will escort your ship to Earth space dock.
But what about the Klingons who killed Captain Taggart, sir? Kadic is still out there.
And if he reveals his position, he will be dealt with accordingly. Until then, you are to set a course for our position. Renown out.
Alright, sir. Fuel all the way over there, that'll be right. Bet you the Klingon's gonna make a comeback. Hold it. You got fucked up. Pew pew pew. No, he didn't. I was watching the transmission. He didn't beg like shit. God, you're a terrible liar. Hi-yield, fire the Tajitos. Could one of you talk at a time, please, and not together? Thank you.
First, we must inform the USS Kittimer that... One moment. My communications officer informs me that we are unable to contact the Kittimer. We will proceed to their coordinates to determine if they require assistance, and your ship will accompany us.
Okey-doke.
I hereby grant you a field promotion. This will give you the proper authority over your crew, and final decision-making ability for your ship until we reach Earth space dock and report to Admiral Quinn.
Ooh. See, this is why you do tutorial stuff. You get experience points and all that sort of thing. Hyper impulse engines, Mark 1. Auxiliary phaser beam array, Mark 1. Phaser split beam rifle, Mark 1. Sweet, and we get Zara.
Congratulations, Lieutenant.
Okay. Nothing around? No anomalies. I am going to quickly outfit my ship before we go anywhere. Just bear with me for a quick moment here. This one does a damage of 143.6 phaser damage, which is 114.9 damage per second. It is better by 10.7 points. It also has a plus 10% to accuracy, so we are going to fit that. Is there anything else? No. Devices? None. Shields? None. Deflector? None. Impulse engines? There were better impulse engines. Flight speed is 0.1 slower. The turn rate is the same. Thrusters 25% speed when engines are disabled. All power to engines plus 66.6 flight speed. Diverts all power to engines. Okay, so full impulse is faster. Standard is 0.1 slower. So we'll fit that. And do we have a warp core? No. Consoles, tactical, science, engineering. No. Go to myself. Alright, we're going to replace that one. And what have we got here? Oh, that's what the other two have. This one will do 45.4 damage per second. It is a 21.6 phaser damage times 2. Because it can shoot better. It is a better weaponer. So we'll put that one on. On my body is nothing. Shield. Standard. Right. No kit. Devices. Let's grab the other hyperspray. Okay. Right. Sweet. Exit sector space. Okay.
Hold the X button to bring up your Captain Commands menu, select Primary Mission, and then select Travel to automatically fly to your destination.
Okay. I'm going to leave that there. We'll do the next mission in the next episode. So this is kind of the way I'm going to go about it. Basically about one or two missions an episode. Try and keep them within an hour in length. I've now been recording for about an hour and 20 minutes. I'm going to do as little editing as possible. I will have to cut out a bit of copyright material here and there because we did have a bit of music playing during a video clip that decided to play, which was really annoying because that means I have to cut it out. Sorry that this one is sort of a bit long in the beginning. It takes a little bit to really get into it, but you know what? This is Star Trek, really. Star Trek isn't always all action. There's plenty of diplomacy and all that sort of stuff. But, like I said, we'll do about one, maybe two missions an episode. Depends on how long we go for. If I get a mission that takes me half an hour or more, perfect. It'll be remaining at one mission. If I do a mission that I can get done within 10 minutes, then, of course, we will go on and do another one. I basically will be aiming for 15 minutes or over per episode. If I have to go over, I go over. If I have to split things up, I split things up. We'll see how it goes. But the plan is two missions per episode, 15 minutes minimum length, preferably. Approximately 15 minutes minimum length. So that's Star Trek Online. That's the first mission, basically, along with the tutorial. And I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you've enjoyed this video, go ahead and hit that like button down below. While you're there, if you haven't already, go ahead and hit subscribe. And when you've done that, hit the bell icon to get a notification every time I upload. Uploads are Saturday and Sunday mornings at 8:30 a.m. Australian Eastern Standard Time. And I will see you in the next video. Live long and prosper! Seriously, is it that or that? I'm gonna have to check that up myself, but go ahead, make a comment down below.